Today we are going to learn how to find zeros of the polynomial by using a graph. So using the graph we are going to find out the values of x for which the polynomial becomes zero. So zeros of the polynomial we are going to find out by using the graph. So first the given polynomial we have to suppose as y. So y is equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. Every second degree equation, this is a second degree expression, every second degree expression represents a curve. So yesterday we discussed, we will get three types of curves. One curve is not cutting x-axis. One curve is cutting x-axis at only one point. One curve is cutting x-axis at two points. Like this we will get three types of curves. The curve doesn't cut x-axis, the curve is cutting x-axis at only one point, the curve is cutting x-axis at two points. Like this, three types of curves we are getting. So before we do the graph, we should have an idea whether the curve is cutting x-axis or not. If it cuts x-axis, then how many points it is cutting. So to know this, so what we have to do is, we should do some rough work here. So first the given expression you have to take it as x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. Coefficient of x square is called a, that is 1. Coefficient of x is called b, that is minus 5. Constant is called c. X square coefficient is a, so here it is 1. X coefficient is b, that is minus 5. Constant is c. First we have to find b square minus 4ac, that is minus 5 square minus 4ac. Minus 5 square is 25, 4 6 is 24, that is 1. If b square minus 4ac is 1, that is a positive number, then it concludes that curve cuts x-axis at 2 points. If you get b square minus 4ac a positive number, then the curve will be like this. If you get b square minus 4ac 0, then the curve cuts x-axis at only one point. If you get b square minus 4ac negative number, then the curve doesn't cut x-axis. So like these three cases are there. So first we should find out b square minus 4ac, that is a positive number, so we can say that curve cuts x-axis at 2 points. Now those two points also we should find out in rough work, that is x square minus 5x plus 6 is 0. Let us factorize 6 into x square, 6x square. Factors of 6x are here, minus 5x is there, so minus 3x minus 2x. So it is x square, in place of minus 5x let us write minus 3x minus 2x. Here you take x common, x minus 3, minus 2 is common, x minus 3. So the factors are x minus 3, x minus 2. Product of two numbers 0, either first one is 0 or second one is 0. So we will get x is equal to 3, x is equal to 2. That means curve is cutting x-axis at 2 points. It will be like this. Curve is cutting x-axis at 2 points. One is 2x value, the other is 3. So in this way the curve should be. Every second degree equation represents a curve. There are three types of curves. The curve doesn't cut x-axis at any point. The curve is cutting x-axis at only one point. The curve is cutting x-axis at two points. So to know whether the curve is cutting or not, if it cuts at how many points it is cutting, to have this idea, first we should find out b square minus 4ac. X square coefficient is called a, x coefficient is called b, constant is c. Let us find out b square minus 4ac. It is a positive number. If b square minus 4ac is a positive number, then the curve cuts x-axis at two points. So the curve will be like this. What are those 2 points? To know that, let us factorize the given equation. We are getting x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 2. So the curve is cutting x axis at number 2 and 3. So before we do the graph, we should have an idea about the curve. So after getting that, now let us find out the ordered pairs to draw this curve. Here, first we have to take x. For x, we have to substitute the values. After taking x, next x square, next minus 5x, next 6. If we add x square minus 5x and 6, that is called y value. So first we have to take x. Next here the terms involved in the expression x square minus 5x and 6. If you add all the 3, that is y value. So for x we have to substitute 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and plus 4. Like this we have to substitute the values for x. If you substitute x is equal to 0, 0 square is 0, minus 5 into 0 is 0, plus 6 we have to add. If you add all the 3, that is 6. So the first ordered pair is 0, 6. Next, if you substitute x is equal to 1, 1 square is 1, minus 5 into 1, minus 5, 6. If you add these 3, 7 minus 5 is 2. So it is 1, 2. Next, put x is equal to 2. 2 square is 4, minus 5 into 2 is minus 10, 6. Let us add these 3. 6 plus 4, 10 minus 10 is 0. So 2 comma 0. Next, x is equal to 3. 3 square is 9, minus 5 into 3, minus 15 plus 6. Add these 3. 15 minus 15, we will get 0. Next, minus 1. Minus 1 whole square is 1. Minus 5 into minus 1 is 5. 6. If you add these 3, that is 12. Next, minus 2. Minus 2 whole square is 4. Minus 5 into minus 2 is 10. 6. If you add these 3, that is 20. Next, minus 3. Minus 3 square is 9. Minus 5 into minus 3 is 15. This is 6. Let us add this 3. It is 30. Next, minus 4. Minus 4 square is 16. Minus 5 into minus 4 is 26. This is 26. 32, 42. Next, x is equal to 4. 4 square is 16. Minus 5 into 4 minus 26. If you add 22 minus 20 is 2. So these are the ordered pairs. Here, we know the answer. Answer is 2 and 3. So for remaining numbers, if you get a bigger value, for example, on substituting minus 4, x is equal to minus 4, we got 42. So there is no need of plotting this point because it is 42
a big number because we know the answer 2 and 3. So just we calculated all the points, but there is no compulsion to plot these points. First point is first point is 0, 6, x value is 0, y value is 6 here. Next 1, 2, x value is 1, y value is 2. Next 2, 0, x value is 2, y value is 0 here. Next point is 3, 0, x value is 3, y value is 0. 3, 0. 4, x value is 4, y value is 2, x value is 4, y value is 2 here. Now when x is minus 1, y value is 12. When x is minus 1, y value is 12. Here you can plot in your graph paper. Now if you join the points without scale, we should join the points. So we will get a curve. This curve is cutting x axis at 2 points. 2, 3. This point is 2, 0. This point is 3, 0. So the curve is cutting x axis at 2 points. 2, 0, 3, 0. X coordinates of these points are the values of x. X coordinate is here 2, here 3. So therefore, the curve is cutting x-axis at 2, 0, 3, 0. Therefore, solution set is 2, 3. Right, next example. Find the zeros of the polynomial P of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 6 using a graph. First, let us complete the rough one. Let us take x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. Coefficient of x square is called a, that is 1. Coefficient of x is called b, that is 5. Constant is c, that is 6. First, let us find out b square minus 4ac, that is 5 square minus 4ac.
25 minus 24, that is 1. Here b square minus 4ac, we got a positive number. If b square minus 4ac is a positive number, therefore curve cuts x-axis at 2 points. Let us find out those 2 points. For finding the 2 points, we should factorize the given expression. X square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. 6 into x square, 6x square. Now here 5x is there, 6x square factors are 3x into 2x. If you have, it is 5x, if you multiply, it is 6x square. So the factors are x square plus 3x plus 2x plus 6 is 0. Here you take x common, it is x plus 3 plus 2 is common, it is x plus 3. So the factors are x plus 3 and x plus 2. Product of two numbers 0, either first one is 0 or second one is 0. So x value is minus 3 or x value is minus 2. That means the curve is cutting x axis at 2 points like this. So the curve is cutting x-axis at 2 points, one is minus 2, the other is minus 3. So first we have to find b square minus 4ac. If it is a positive number, then we can say that curve cuts x-axis at 2 points. To know those 2 points, by factorization method we should find out x values minus 3 and minus 2. That means the curve is cutting x-axis at minus 2 and minus 3. Now to draw the curve, we should find the ordered pairs. So let us take the given expression x square plus 5x plus 6. The given expression we have to consider as y. For x we should substitute 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Here we have to take the terms given in the expression. First one is x square, next 5x, next 6. If you add these 3, that is y value. Substitute x is equal to 0, 0 square is 0, 5 into 0 is 0 plus 6. If you add these 3, that is 6. So the first ordered pair is 0, 6. Next put x is equal to 1, 1 square is 1, 5 into 1, 5, 6. So if you add these 3, that is 12. Substitute x is equal to 2, 2 square is 4, 5 2 is 10. 6. If you add these 3, that is 20. Now put x is equal to 3. 3 square is 9. 5 3 is 15 plus 6. This is 15 plus 15, 30. Put x is equal to minus 1. Minus 1 whole square is 1. 5 into minus 1 is minus 5 plus 6. If you add them, it is 2. Next, x is equal to minus 2. Minus 2 square is 4. 5 into minus 2 is minus 10, 6. If you add these 3, that is 0. Next, put x is equal to minus 3. Minus 3 square is 9. 5 into minus 3 is minus 15, 6. This is 15 minus 15, it is 0. Next, put x is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 square is 16. 5 into minus 4 is minus 20. This is 22 minus 20 is 2. So So like this we should find out the ordered pairs. After finding the ordered pairs, we should draw the graph. Here we know the answer. Answer is minus 2, minus 3. Wherever we got y value 0, that x value is called the answer. So minus 2, minus 3. First point is 0, 6, x is 0, y is 6. Second point is 1, 12, x value is 1, y value is 12 here. Now in your graph the bigger numbers you can plot, 2, 20, 3, 20. Now minus 1, 2, x value is minus 1, y value is 2 here. Minus 2 comma 0, x value is minus 2, y value is 0. Next minus 3, 0, x value is minus 3, y value is 0. Next minus 4, 2, x value is minus 4 here, y value is 2 here. Now you join them. So you will get a curve. This curve is cutting x-axis at 2 points. The curve is cutting x-axis at 2 points, minus 2, 0, minus 3, 0. So x-coordinates of these points is the value of x, that is zeros of the polynomial. So solution set is minus 2, minus 3. Like this we should find out. So here the curve is cutting x-axis at 2 points, minus 2, 0, minus 3, 0. X coordinates of these points are the zeros of the polynomial. So answer is minus 2, minus 3.